One of the films that I really, 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 really love and I can go back to it 8 million times is Bombay and Dil Se.
One of my earliest memories of watching a film and being completely enthralled by it and actually wanting to step into the frame, it was Manisha Koirala in white singing Kehna Hi Kya and those chicks and, you know, that ethereal, you know, quality and just the way that it was filmed. At that age, you don't really know what it is that makes it feel like that. But subsequently, every time I've watched Bombay, like I said, you know, those layers come off and it just becomes more and more and more and more, including the love story, including the whole Babri Masjid issue, including the fact that the transgender person saves the child. Like, so many little things that Manisha adds, and he just puts them in without sort of announcing it on a mic that I am doing this. It's so much a part of who he is. These little things that he puts into his film, that I think that has been my most amazing memory and then my first memory of a film where I actually wanted to be Manisha Koirala. And Dil Se, I don't know, when you're much younger, you know, a lot of peripheral things also make a huge difference to your life, I mean, apart from the story. So here was somebody, I mean, Manisha envisioned this girl who was the heroine of his film, and it was a heroine like I had never seen before, where she had absolutely no makeup. She was so vulnerable and so stunningly beautiful, but so strong. Like, she was on strong and silent type. You know, like, we feel strength means you shout and scream and you hold a knife in your hand, but she was strong. She held her own till the very end. So it was the first time that you actually saw somebody like that. And also that love story, though I know Manisha's films get a lot of mixed responses in terms of, because he never makes you comfortable with what he's saying. There's always some debate in his characters, in his style of filmmaking. I think this love story was one of those most beautiful love stories. Very passionate, very problematic, very flawed, but very timeless. And I'm quite a sucker for that kind of romance. If you like this video, please subscribe to Film Companion.